UW-Madison researchers are working with a pair of biotech companies to develop a possible vaccine for the coronavirus. And I'm joined now live by Eric Hamilton. He joins us over the phone. He's a spokesperson for development and testing of the CoroFlu vaccine. Thanks so much for joining us. So we mentioned, two researchers from UW-Madison are working on this, but this is really an international effort. It's an international collaboration. So tell us a little bit about that.
Yeah, that's right. So this is a collaboration with Drs. Yoshihiro Kawaoka and Gabrielle Newman at UW-Madison and the Madison-based biotech company FluGen, which was co-founded by Drs. Kawaoka and Newman. But they're also collaborating with Bharat Biotech in India. And in part, that's because they have an ongoing relationship with Bharat. And part of that ongoing relationship is the fact that Bharat was actually founded by a UW-Madison alum. So this is really coming together nicely to try to put this vaccine out there as quickly as possible.
And they are in the early stages of developing this vaccine, but how soon could they begin human testing?
Yeah, that's a great question. It takes time, like with any vaccine, to do the basic research and start testing the effectiveness and safety of the vaccine. What we're expecting right now is that that initial testing here in Madison, particularly in laboratory animal models, will take somewhere between 3 and 6 months. And then they're going to provide the vaccine materials to Bharat Biotech in India, who will scale up for those clinical trials. And we're hoping for starting human clinical trials sometime in the fall.
All right. Well, that would be pretty soon if it starts in the fall, hopefully. And the goal here is for the vaccine to work for both the coronavirus and the flu. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's right. That's what really makes this so unique. What they're doing is they saw an opportunity to work with the flu vaccine candidate that they're developing and that has already gone through a couple clinical trials and add in genetic sequences from the novel coronavirus. If this system works, it would actually be a two-for-one vaccine of sorts against both part of the influenza viruses and then also the novel coronavirus, which would be really great.
And this vaccine, you know, they're planning on hopefully having it delivered through the nose. Is that right?
Yeah, that's right. You might have seen this with, for example, the vaccines that were against the H1N1 influenza pandemic in 2009 and 2010. That kind of delivery can be more effective at producing immune responses where the infection takes place, which is the nose and the throat and the lungs. Most flu vaccines, of course, are given as a shot through the arm, which is usually pretty effective, but this intranasal delivery system might prove even better in this case.
Well, it's pretty neat that we have a Wisconsin connection in this effort of finding a coronavirus vaccine. Eric, thank you so much for your time. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.